Hey guys, how's everyone doing? My name is Obi and welcome to a new episode from my FIFA 14 team review series. If you are looking to buy some cheap and reliable Ultimate Team coins, go check fifacoinstoday.com and use the code OVI, that's OVVY, for a 10% discount at every single purchase. How cool is that? You just enter the code and boom, 10% off. So, for the ones that are new on my channel and new to this series, it's all about giving you guys the best lineups, formations and tactics for the major teams in FIFA 14. It's now time for the guys that invented this beautiful game. Of course, I am talking about the English national team. I picked for them the 4-2-2 and the 3-5-2. Both are very standard formations and you get a nice balance between defense and attack. They have very fast wingers, so you need to take advantage of that. Play a lot of low passes to them, they'll get free and they will be able to get a lot of crosses in for those strikers. In defense, I was hesitating a bit between Jagielka, I don't know if I pronounced this guy's name correctly, and Cahill, but I choose the first one because he has such a nice combo of height and jumping ability. He reminds me a lot of Ramos. Kyle Walker is a must because of his incredible speed. He can cover a lot of ground and that is essential when you are playing with three defenders. Smalling as a central defender is pretty nice. His biggest quality is that he is tall and big. He doesn't have any special attributes, but being so big helps him get the job done. As CDM, I am using two different combinations for players depending on the formation I use. For the 3-5-2, I needed to use players that are more defensively oriented, being the case here with Baines, and even if Gerrard is more offensively oriented, he is still better in defense than my other combination of CDMs, which is Rooney and Wilshere. I particularly enjoyed the second pair of CDMs because it was more fun to play with them. Rooney's outside shots were so nice to use and Wilshere is good at covering a lot of ground. He is a very nice box-to-box midfielder. In the 3-5-2, I used Rooney as a central attacking midfielder and I must say, he was by far the best player in the team. He performed very, very well, great combo of power and composure. And just knowing that you can make a nice outside shot with him makes him so much more dangerous in that position. In attack, Sturridge and Welbeck are pretty good, both with nice aerial capabilities, but 3 stars weak foot makes them very limited when it comes to finishing, so you always have to try and be on their dominant foot, else you risk missing your opportunities. Defoe is a good option for the attack also, he has better finishing than Welbeck and Sturridge, but the bad thing about him is that he is very, very small. Another option is to substitute him as a central attacking midfielder and put Rooney in attack instead of Sturridge or Welbeck. So guys, this was my review of the English national team. Hope you enjoyed it. I know it will help you a lot. Just listen to my advices and everything will be very, very good for you. As you can see, I added myself to the video with a green screen. Drop a comment below and tell me your opinion about it. I hope the quality is decent. I am still working a bit with the settings of the green screen and hopefully I will have a better quality in the next videos. If you appreciate my work, don't forget to drop a like and share the video with your friends and don't forget to subscribe for more FIFA 14 content coming to you as soon as possible.